It feels like everybody just agrees that a September Nintendo Direct is inevitable. I mean, at this point, the common thread, the frame of mind of just about every Nintendo fan is that this is happening, and we're all here just waiting for Nintendo to tweet out exactly what day it'll take place. There have been so many rumors, so much speculation, so many leaks and pictures of Watermelon Mario floating around this past week that it's gotten pretty crazy. And things are definitely ramping up, things are definitely heating up, and I'm here to compile everything together, bring you some new info, and give you the Switch Force take. What's going on, everybody? It's Zach from Switch Force, and this is super exciting, because the September Direct is a good one, and the September Direct always comes less than 2 weeks after the August Indies. That's how it's been in the Switch era, so it's very easy to get on board with these kinds of predictions and rumors. Plus, they're cool shows. Back in 2017, Nintendo announced both Doom and Wolfenstein 2, and then Doom dropped just a couple months later in November. So it's very likely that something announced at this September Direct may in fact release this year. Definitely let me know in the comments down below how you feel about a September Direct and all of these different rumors from different places, and what game you're most excited to see. If you could have one game at this Direct, what would it be? Let me know in the comments down below. Hit that like button if you're ready for a new Nintendo show. This all began with some more GameStop SKUs. What happens here is GameStop adds new Switch SKUs to their system, and then usually they're filled shortly after. It happened back at E3, about 10 new SKUs, and then boom, they were filled with new titles. Well, now we've got a lot of new SKUs in GameStop system. First, it was like 12, now it's about 18. I'm gonna show you this tweet from New Wabi Sabi, who was so good at E3 leaks that he almost got shut down and was basically told not to talk about Nintendo. He has shown a GameStop computer screen with a lot of coming Switch games. Now, you'll notice the placeholder date, don't worry about it. That's just what's always given for things like this, is a December 31st date. So we have no idea if these are 2019 titles, 2020 titles, what they could be, if it's a game, if it's a bundle, who knows? But there's a lot being added, and that means they'll probably be revealed and filled shortly. That's the basis for most September Direct speculation right now, on top of what I already mentioned about the pattern of things, how Nintendo does an Indies in August and then does a Direct in September less than 2 weeks after. We had Indie World on the 19th, so it makes sense that we get a Direct in September and probably early, but remember that. We'll touch on why I think it's early a little later. Now we get to the fun part where we get to discuss Mario and his messy watermelon eating, because Nintendo tweeted this innocuous little image of Mario enjoying his summer vacation, and it says, "Even Mario needs a little summer vacation. No matter where your summer odyssey took you, we hope it was filled with sunshine." Now, aren't Nintendo punning? They put both Odyssey and Sunshine in a picture of Mario looking very Odyssey-esque, doing very Sunshine-esque things, vacations and fruits. Since then, things have blown up. People all over are speculating, maybe this means Super Mario Sunshine 2. Maybe this means Super Mario Sunshine ported to Switch. Maybe this means Super Mario Sunshine DLC in Mario Odyssey. Maybe this means Mario Odyssey 2 featuring Super Mario Sunshine. It is a lot of chaos and a lot of noise. And then people were quick to find that Nintendo was putting fruit at their Gamescom sets. They showed a watermelon when discussing Luigi's Mansion 3, and then they dropped a pineapple on the table during the Zelda Link's Awakening segment. And everyone started to think that maybe something is really, really, really close to happening for Mario Sunshine. But then there was some pause, because in the Luigi's Mansion 3 demo, there were giant watermelons, and in the Link's Awakening demo, there was a pineapple as part of a big side quest. So perhaps these fruits were just coincidental and matched up nicely with what they had to show for their big fall releases. But it's also odd that Mario was on the table in front of said fruits. At the same time though, Mario is Nintendo, so it makes sense that he'd be there. I mean, they also had a telephone in front of the pineapple. Does that mean a Zelda mobile game is right around the corner? Maybe they're just superstars at hinting, but I'd like to think that perhaps this isn't as intense as everyone is making it out to be. Nintendo often puts Mario in fun outfits and relatable situations. I saw someone tweet out a picture where Mario was getting ready for a flight at an airport and he had luggage and there were stickers on the suitcase. And if you read into that, maybe you'd think there was a crossover between Zelda and Mario, and obviously that never happened. But it is a bit odd that this is most definitely the Odyssey Mario instead of the more standard Mario that we'd see in something like Super Mario Maker 2 marketing materials. Then again, maybe that's the render that they wanted to work with, and perhaps this means nothing. But if there is a seed there, if there's something that can grow into a reality, I think it's most likely, I have no clue. I'm gonna be totally honest with you and say I have no clue, because I don't think any of the options I've seen are particularly likely. Or rather, they're all equally likely, and so nothing super stands out. I mean, Mario Odyssey DLC kind of makes sense because of all the Isle Delfino stuff we saw associated with Odyssey before launch, but at the same time, we're 2 years beyond the release of Super Mario Odyssey, and so DLC would be a bit awkward. At the same time, a Super Mario Sunshine port doesn't make a ton of sense, given that we're hopeful for Super Nintendo games, so jumping to GameCube seems unlikely. Mario Odyssey 2, I guess, could happen, and maybe they'd love to have a 3D Mario shortly after the release of the Switch Lite, but there's no way that that happens this year, so would they be teasing something a year down the road? I don't know. Piranha Plant in my head, I'm saying that this is just pure coincidence. Nintendo's having fun, summer's almost over, and they like the idea of Mario messily eating watermelon. But let's get to some juicy stuff, and here's the part that I haven't seen many people mention. I'm gonna walk you back to Emily Rogers' list of mystery games. This happened way back near the beginning of 2019, and if you don't know, Emily Rogers is our girl that talks a lot about Switch stuff and usually is vague, but often very right. And at the beginning of the year, she made this list of mystery games. Since then, most of them have been filled. In fact, all of them but two have been revealed slash released. Mystery Game 1 was Astral Chain, Mystery Game 2 was Link's Awakening, Mystery Game 3 was Super Mario Maker 2, Mystery Game number 4 is still a mystery. There was an eShop game that eventually became Tetris 99, an eShop game that became Box Boy plus Box Girl, Cadence of Hyrule, the new Labo kit was Labo VR, and there's also a Wii U port from 2013. Now this has been speculated as either Super Mario 3D World or Pikmin 3, but past leaks and scuttlebutt have us thinking that it's more likely Pikmin 3, and some things that King Zell have said, another Nintendo leaker, back this up. So we've got these two mystery games that have yet to be shown or seen, and Emily Rogers actually came in yesterday with some new details about what exactly is going on. Regarding the Wii U port, she said that it will most likely get bumped to early 2020, and that it'll be taking the new Super Mario Bros. U Deluxe slot, probably releasing in January or February. Now this would be super awesome, whether it is Pikmin 3 or Super Mario 3D World. Either of those would be a nice addition, and I'd be okay with double dipping on both. I'm dying for more Pikmin action, and hey, Mario 3D World is, I think, one of the best Mario games ever released, so both of those would fit nicely on the Switch. I'm not a super fan of Wii U ports, but if it's gonna happen, those are great choices. But I'm more interested in her follow-up comment, and I think you will be too. Someone on Reset Era said, if that's the case, that would mean no December game this year. I guess fall lineup is better this year, so maybe they won't need a December game, as they had last year in Super Smash Bros. Ultimate. But then Emily Rogers comes in and sets the internet ablaze. She says, well, I only said Wii U port number one, the 2013 game, was likely to get bumped to early 2020. I didn't comment on mystery game number four, which is also on the same list. Smiley face. Here implying that mystery game number 4 still could see a 2019 release date and could be Nintendo's December title. So now the current train of thought is that there is a first party Nintendo title, a AAA store shelves title, coming in December of 2019 that has yet to be revealed and could be the central focus of this new Direct. So now the new train of thought is that there may be a new Nintendo first-party Switch title releasing in stores in December. This wouldn't be an eShop game, this wouldn't be a port, this would be a new major title still to be revealed and still to be released this year. And by all accounts, it would be a very central focus of the coming September Direct. Now again, who knows, grains of salt, rumors, speculation, yada yada, but Emily Rogers is pretty spot on and she's still confident in her list that has bared a lot of fruit thus far. Now in terms of what specific title this mystery game number 4 may be, your guess is as good as mine. I've seen some people really focus on the number 4 and say it's gotta be Pikmin 4 or Golden Sun 4, but I think those are just jokes. A lot of people have thrown out Rare as a legitimate possibility, given how often a project from them is rumored. I've also seen Monolith Soft, but I think at this point, trying to take a stab at what game could release from Nintendo in December and fill this mystery slot, it's kind of rolling the dice, so we'll save that for a little farther down the road. But what I do want to talk about is the timing of this September Direct. I've seen a number of people say they think it'll happen later in the month due to a certain Nintendo anniversary. You see, Nintendo Switch Online memberships will roll over on September 18th, as that is the day this thing was born a year ago. Now, obviously, we have the SNES wireless controllers rumor, which has everyone believing SNES games will be coming to the online platform, and it's a pretty cool birthday gift for a service that is definitely lacking. September 18th is a Wednesday, and directs do often happen during the middle of the week, so that lines up, but there's something happening that week that is far more important to Nintendo than a direct. Nintendo Switch Lite and Zelda Link's Awakening launched that Friday on September 20th. Now, I don't think that they can really have Nintendo Switch Online's anniversary, the Switch Lite launch, Link's Awakening launch, and a Direct with new projects including games that will be releasing this year, plus fanfare and birthday presents for Switch Online, all in a 3-day span. That seems like a crazy, monumental task for marketing, and I feel like they would much rather spread things out. So I'm pegging September 4th or 5th as the day. Remember, 2 weeks is usually what happens between indie presentations and directs. Indie World was on the 19th, so the first week of September lines up. Plus, that gives them a 2-week buffer between whatever they announce and promote and the Switch Lite and Link's Awakening. That's a valid amount of time. Also, if you want to get people excited about renewing their Switch Online membership before it lapses, then you do that on a day before it lapses, not the exact day of the anniversary. You'd want to give them some time to decide if they want to re-up. And that's why September 4th or 5th, 2 weeks before, makes sense. You can announce that, hey, SNES games are coming on the anniversary. That would be a great surprise, but give them some time to get ready for it and also get people excited to subscribe for the first time. I know Nintendo likes shadow drops, and boy do I love them, but let's not get too crazy. Cramming all of that into 1 3-day cycle seems like an insane undertaking for not only Nintendo, but for coverage in general. So here we go. September Directs have been a thing since the Switch launched. September Directs 2 weeks after an indie presentation have also been a thing every year since the Switch launched. So pattern, repetition, and routine are on our side. GameStop is listing a bunch of Switch SKUs, as many as 18, and that is a ton, which also bodes well for a potential Direct. Mario is enjoying his watermelon and his summer vacation, and while I don't think it means much, if you want to squeeze some hope out of this that maybe something sunshine happens sometime soon, well then there's another notch towards a September presentation presenting new information and new products. Emily Rogers and her very accurate list still has 2 empty slots, Mystery Game number 4 and Wii U Port number 1. Recent comments from Emily herself add nudges and nods to the idea that Wii U port number 1 has been bumped to early 2020, but Mystery Game number 4 still is being released this year and possibly in December. Timing-wise, early September makes more sense, especially when you consider the precedent of 2 weeks after an indie presentation, we got our September Direct. Plus, that third week in September will be absolutely flooded with Nintendo coverage due to the Switch Online anniversary, the Switch Lite launch, and Link's Awakening coming to the platform. So everything is adding up, guys and girls, to a September Direct. It really feels like this is happening, and this is happening soon. Those GameStop SKUs are exciting by their sheer number. The fact that Emily Rogers thinks a Nintendo-published product may still release this year is incredible, and if you're a big fan of sunshine, then maybe you do have a sunny, delicious day on the horizon. But either way, let me know your take in the comments down below. I really think this is happening, and I think it's happening in the first week of September. So hopefully we have awesome stuff to look forward to and get excited about. I think it's safe to get excited. I know it's always grains of salt and rumors and speculation and yada yada and who knows and leaks and blah, but there's a lot here. And there's a lot here that seems likely, makes sense, and comes from reliable sources. So I think we're getting it. If you ask me, it's the first week of September, and I am super freaking excited. But let me know your take in the comments down below. Smash that like button if you are ready for the next Direct. And until next time, everybody, have a fantastic day. Hope you enjoyed the video. Hope it was informative, helpful, and fun. Switch Force out.